8 of Advent, Micah chapter 2, verses 8 to 11. Lately, my people have risen up like an enemy. You strip off the rich robe from those who pass by without a care, like men returning from battle. You drive the women of my people from their pleasant homes. You take away my blessing from their children forever. Get up, go away, for this is not your resting place, because it is defiled. It is ruined beyond all remedy. If a liar and deceiver comes and says, I will prophesy for you plenty of wine and beer, that would be just the prophet for this people. I wonder what would be the prophet for people today. I'm sure many would like a prophet who prophesied plenty of wine and beer, plenty of wealth and leisure, plenty of freedom, plenty of immorality. A prophet who said it didn't matter that you stole, that you were wicked towards women, that you took away good things from children. What kind of liar and deceiver do you want? What is it that you'd like them to tell you? That's fine. That's what the Lord wants for you. That's what I am prophesying for you. It would be nice, would it not, to have someone tell us that God is exactly the way we'd like him to be. Forgiving, yes. Generous, of course. Uncaring, perhaps. Distant, unconcerned, ignorant, incompetent, impotent. Is that really what we want? A society where it's okay to steal, to harm women, to destroy children. Listen. Listen to the prophet of the true God. Listen. Listen to tomorrow's verses, what it is that God will do. And consider this. What God do you want? The God of your own imagination, or the sovereign creator God who will judge all things? Collect for the second Sunday in Advent. Blessed Lord, who has caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, grant that we may in such wise hear them, read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that by patience and comfort of thy holy word, we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life, which thou hast given us in our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.